Curve. This is where you get all your entertainment news live and direct at the comfort of your homes. My name is Laura Mbatha, and I make sure you get the latest and the top when it comes to entertainment news right here on KTN Home. And of course, I'm here joined by my very, very talented co-hosts who've been here last week and they're here again, because why not? If it's nice, do it twice. And on my closest ranks, we have Stevens Mwendo.
You know what?
Looking dapper.
Stevens Mwendo, thank you so much, Laura.
Today.
I mean, you're used to this thing yourself.
You keep going.
Ah, come on, she's pushing it now. Well, Stevens Mwendo, your main man for the event. And you know what? We've been there, done that. Mm-hmm. We are going back there to do that again. And so, we are here to have a lot of fun tonight.
I like that.
Isha, with a long name.
Well, everybody, my name is Isha, sweet, sassy, and I want to see where this E-curve is taking me tonight.
All right. So, all right. Guys, we want to keep it very fun and interesting. Being the month of love, we're not even going to get into that. But as far as these people know, I am their master. I will be their spelling master because we want to play a very little game called Spelling Bee.
I was so excited for this.
Spelling Bee.
And for you, Stevens, being the month of love, I want you to spell intimacy.
Intimacy? I've been editing all day, so I-N-T-I-M-S-C-Y. If I was to listen to my son, he'd be saying cool, too hard, plus some other things.
You know, if I were you, I'd say I-N-T-I-M-A-C.
Is that right?
Intimacy.
You're very right. And right. Now for Isha,
I'm ready.
The word lucrative.
Lucrative.
Yes.
Can I have a definition?
Well, that is my future boyfriend. The requirement.
So I'm guessing lucrative is lucrative. Along the lines of money.
Absolutely.
So wait a minute, Laura, why are you asking me to spell lucrative? I thought we're in a love Valentine's edition of spelling
bee. Listen here, contrary to popular belief, love does cost a thing. Love costs a lot of money, if you ask me. But we're getting into that on eBuzz, so stick around. Popular social media page Mpasho came up with a question that asked, ladies, which bills do you expect your boyfriend to regularly cater for? And of course, Kenyans came through and answered questions. Personally, I expect him to pay for my mental health bills because the things Nairobi men will
character
put you through.
Development.
The
character
things Nairobi men will put you through. I can't even afford Isha and she hasn't even graduated.
Are you talking about men paying bills or all of us pay bills for each other?
Listen, the question here is, what bills?
Wait. I have something to say about this. In this day and age, why are we relying on people to pay our bills? First things first, get that degree, secure that bag. Even if you're not getting a degree, at least secure the bag.
First of all, Beyonce chapter, Destiny's Child, verse 6, can you pay my bills? My telephone bill?
My automobile.
She moved on to Renaissance, so we're not there anymore.
It's fine. Listen, me, I stick with the Old Testament Beyonce, OG Beyonce, where she used to be Destiny's Child, holding down things, and she asks a very important question. Can you pay my bills? So, Stevens, as a guy, sometimes we really try and give you the center station and pretend like your opinion counts for something. I'm joking. Men's opinions do count for something. What do you think?
I think men should stand for something anyway.
Yes, they do.
When you go into a relationship or whatever sort, I think a man should take a stand and be responsible for something.
Yeah.
You are not taking somebody's girl for a friend if you cannot even buy a lunch or something or get her right something. And I think, for real, I will not be able to answer for every man who's talking about what bills I can pay for or not. But basically the basics. As long as it's not that thing for Tuma Fair every time it's not working.
Oh my God. Can you imagine every time you want to meet your wifey, you want to send her 400 bob for Uber?
Listen, I think I'm coming into my Tuma Fair era because young me was always just struggling to show up, you know. I'm going to do the, then if you have kitamba kangu, I wipe my feet before I come to your house because I'm trying to look nice. Listen, it's my era to Tuma Fair. So if you're interested in this fine way,
Tuma Fair.
No, but on a serious note, I feel like relationships are balanced. It's never usually 50-50 because even for me, I know the position I am in. and to expect men to cater for everything. I think society has moved to a place where a double income relationship.
Yeah, for sure.
Nairobi girls don't want
wait. Listen. Yeah. What do we feel about the 50-50 thing? Because, you know, there's different opinions to the whole 50-50 thing. Like, 50-50 could mean 50% is I exist and you pay my bills. That's 50-50. But on contrary to that, like, I know it's always just a joke. Like, you know, men should be paying the bills. Men are breadwinners, blah, blah, blah. But do we really think it's 50-50? My personal opinion, I think whatever you bring to the table should be expected at the table.
Exactly. I mean, we all have something to bring. And communication is the biggest thing. Mm. So you understand your partner's needs. We don't need to put all the burden on men. First of all, economy people to buy. Well, anyway, listen, as I said, as my man looking at this, you just have to have a lucrative career.
Do you want to be a housewife, though?
It's not looking bad.
When the divorce comes, it's 50-50 again. They
So I
when
you
part ways again,
but definitely
50-50,
something
you
that
have lost everything.
I mean,
we're
all just trying to live at the end of the day, respecting people's boundaries, understanding each other is very important. So the money thing for me is not a big deal, but you just have to have money. And speaking of money,
I mean, for the longest time we haven't had this. Real money women. We talked about. And a week ago, we got to know somebody we'd be waiting for all this time. Laura looks like she's been in this money thing. I'm talking about the Real Housewives of Nairobi.
Can you stop it right here?
We've had the Real Housewives of Joburg, the Real Housewives Ghana, Accra,
Atlanta,
Lagos, Atlanta, and everywhere. Until Nairobi happened, the Real Housewives of Nairobi. Happening in Kenya, Nairobi. Just take a look.
Okay.
If you want to find boss in Nairobi, look no further.
Toast in luxury. Cheers to that. We run this city, period. You're more Kenyan than all other Kenyans.
Nazari Usana.
You said I'm bringing drama. I brought the change.
You brought it, sis.
I'm here and I'm very comfortable.
Party.
I am not leaving. It's not so party.
I mean, you've seen the trailer for yourselves. We're not just talking about something that's not happening. And that's my friend Susan Katani. I mean, just they're ranting drama all the way.
Living, period.
We have this. Five women, some of them, I think all of them, we know them so well, all the way from Lisa, Christabel, Sonal, Vera,
Mine.
Do you think that they rep the Real Housewives of Nairobi?
Can I just say something? Because I have something to say.
First of all,
I'm living for the brand representation on a Nairobi-based TV show.
What do you mean?
Like Sonal, she's somebody I've seen for very many years. As a brown girl, I always like thought, like, damn, you know, she's really living. She's winning.
Yeah.
She's getting her bag. She's so independent. She's doing her thing. And to see her as a representation for my skin color on a screen that has been predominantly
so
not my skin color.
Definitely.
Sonal is my... I'm rooting for Sonal. In fact, I've known her for a bit.
Right.
And she's such a... lovely person. She brings this class and the sense of luxury to everything she does. So 100% I'm rooting for you, Sonal.
First of all, not Isha complaining when there's a billion dollar Bollywood industry thriving out there talking about representation. First of all,
are you going to cancel me for
You're canceled. You're canceled.
You're canceled, by the way.
Second, what does a housewife mean? Don't you need to be married? I'm just saying. Don't come for me.
They're real.
But listen, to be honest, I think it's a fantastic cast. Despite what people are complaining about Vera being part of the cast. First of all, can you grow up? Show us your money.
Yeah.
She's shown us her money. She's shown us borrowing. We've seen the dark side and the bright side. What do you mean by dark side and bright side?
Is that a double entendre?
It was, and I'm so happy you got that. But listen, she's in her brightest era yet.
Right.
So I really need to stop. But honestly, I'm happy with the cast. I think they're fantastic women. They bring in so much energy, like she said. Sonal is such a fashion icon.
All of them are icons.
Yeah.
And when I speak about icons... and I think of a wife and I think of a woman in power.
The first
name that pops into my mind. Any guesses? Queen?
I will give our viewer the next 1 week when the show drops. Yeah. Right. Then we will have this talk again.
We'll talk about it. Right. But while we think on that and while we wait for the show to come out, I want to talk about women in power. And one of them is Queen Bee. Mm-hmm. Okay. Beyonce was just, she won a Grammy.
Yeah.
And she has...
She won Grammys.
She won Grammys. Plural. Hey, hey, English. My English is not Englishing today, but she was nominated for so many Grammys, right, out of which she was victorious in so many and won so many. And she is now holding a record for most Grammys won ever. Mm. Forget in this lifetime, your lifetime, Jana, ever. She has won the most Grammys.
Right.
What do we think about that? Is Beyonce like losing her charm? Is this now just something that we're waiting to die down? Is this an era coming to an end? Is this like just something bringing back things? Like, what do we think about that?
Did you say losing her charm or something? First of all, the Grammys were very outstanding. I was watching the whole show that early morning Monday, and Grammys were outstanding. I mean, the 65th. Mm. I mean, those are like... 65 years of your life.
Yeah. Imagine.
I mean, Grammys have been there. And Beyonce getting a record win of 32.
On the 65th.
And she's 41. Calculate how many years she is in singing and all that. I think she has done her thing in music.
Amazing.
And I wouldn't say Beyonce is overemphasized in any way.
I mean, all I have to say on the issue is if you're in the market, in the black market, in search of an eye, kidney, liver... I'm available. The Renaissance tour must be attended by any means necessary. And I think she's a fantastic artist. When you see the documentaries about her performances and how much work she puts in, it just reminds you of how lazy you are.
Oh my God, yes.
How you're doing absolutely nothing. So to say she's overrated because the industry expects people to have a shelf life when it comes to ages.
Right.
Like, I hate this shelf life thing. Because
I'm turning 27 and I'm already feeling like, oh my God, and Dikube said, nimeoza.
Don't mention some people in this show. Laura,
you're about to trend on TikTok. I'm just letting you. Can we manifest this for a second?
Fight me.
Laura, 2023 trending hashtag on TikTok. Laura calls out Kibe.
I'm not calling him out. I'm just saying he said I'm 27. I'm unworthy. And he
you're not.
Forget
you're
about
not.
It. Forget it.
No, I'm saying. Anyway, my point was she's not overrated because she's put in the work to do something that she's passionate about, and she's able to do it until she's 41. Everything else is just jealousy, if you ask me. Because who wouldn't want to be dancing like
I would be jealous.
When you're 41?
I would be
who
very jealous.
Who wouldn't want to be throwing
somebody
like that? Like you're at
if Burna Boy was overrated and he lost that.
I'm speechless.
Let me tell you, being overrated is being a hater. That is what is being overrated. Yeah. If you're not going to do what you love and be passionate about it and be successful, you are overrated. Because it's time people to shine and just be the best versions of themselves. How are we exactly going to be doing after the break by doing a bit of touch-up when it comes to lipstick and eyeshadow? Because we'll be right back right here on eCar with some more entertainment news.
Work, work, work. Work's over. Busy biters, get down to snack business. When snacking is under attack, we'll be there to fight back.
Here's the secret to tasty meals every day. Salit, a triple refined vegetable oil for fresh, crispy food. Salit oil is cholesterol free. Salit, Siri, Dio Hio.
Work, work, work. Work's over. Busy biters, get down to snack business. When snacking is under attack, we'll be there to fight back.
Looking for a home investment in a serene neighborhood? Centum Real Estate presents Cascadia Apartments, a Two Rivers development in Nairobi. You are only a few minutes walk to our 4DX cinema, retail shopping and restaurants. Your kids get to enjoy play areas at our theme parks. Enjoy our Valentine's discount offer of up to 500,000 shillings. Deposit 920,000 shillings. Pay balance in flexible installments or mortgage financed from your SACO or bank. Talk to us on 0742-342-722.
Work, work, work. What's over? Busy biters, get down to snack business. When snacking is under attack, we'll be there to fight back.
Tomorrow night on KTN.
Get 2 months of Showmax for the price of one? What? In a give. In a give girl power. That blink binge. Hey, squamaka. And legendary action hero energy. Whoa. The thrills and chills keep out. For the streets. In a give, Kupindukia. So subscribe now to get 2 months from only 300 shillings for limited time. In a give Showmax.
This week on We Debate.
Does freedom of speech include the right to offend?
Anybody who wants to offend is malicious. It's malice, mens rea in law.
For freedom of expression to exist, one, all of us must hold an opinion.
Why do you want to offend? Why?
Even the key, maybe let's say two political figures in this country, when you listen to most of their speeches, it's not polite speeches.
There is a threshold within which society has to sanction those who propagate incitement.
Can we fix offending others by outlawing or legislating behavior?
While the rest of the world waits, just know we will bring you the runs again. And we will freeze in the stands with them, fly along with them. Just know that we will sprint and sweat with them. And never will we be late for their practice. We will meet on the mat with them and be spellbound by the legends we meet. We will witness the haka together and be grateful. We will show them doing it again. And when the time comes, we will bring them onto the grandstand.
So welcome back, and yes, as we always told you that this is the best show that tells you where the events were happening last week, this week. We tell you what's going to be happening next week. But before then, we're just going to tell you, we didn't go for the Grammys, of course.
No.
We enjoyed ourselves on our city rooms. But again, yes, Nairobi was happening last weekend. And of course, inside Alliance Francaise, the auditorium was one of the best comedy shows ever to happen in Kenya. And of course, GMO, and I'm not talking about food, I'm talking about Get Me Out, was the comedy that was showing at Allianz. Probably you just need to see this video for us to get you to know that this was a real event happening.
It is not about gender.
The Igbo ones dominate.
It is not about gender.
The Igbo women dominate.
It's not about gender. Just be good. Just whether you're a man or a woman.
I'm not denying the fact that you be good. I agree that part. But also, I'm defending my fellow men.
But you men, to say that you see, was smart.
Huh?
Yeah, but men are just not smart.
And you want me to support women?
Yeah, I'm just
saying. I'm not smart.
Men
I have no problem with men. I have a problem with bad people. Not bad men or bad women.
Mimi ninataka kumalizia fiska. This is what I'm telling you. If a man is doing something, atakuja tu afanye mzima mzima. A woman will hold it inside her. Ni kukaranga, ni kukula na watu wasijue. Hapo ndo tunasema just be nice. Whether you are a woman or a man, mbona unamkaranga?
It's your first time. Why haven't you been showing up at the theater places? Is it not something that you wanted to do before?
I've heard about plays before, but I've never really... I saw high school plays, and to be honest, they were not that amazing. So I imagine that's what happens in the scene. But I'm really impressed because it's like a movie.
Tell us about your role today, which was very intriguing. That movie, you were called the devil, and then you redeemed yourself from that.
Melissa is a very, very mysterious woman. She looks evil because the society maybe doesn't understand her, but she was doing whatever she did because of her son and because she got to a point where nobody's a good person anymore, so why be the good person?
See you again.
Yeah.
How are you doing? Brilliant. Awesome. Yeah. So we have the main man here, the director, Heartstrings Entertainment. Just tell us about some of those things and why theater is busting back into life.
I think the reason why theater is, theater has a natural way of being a tool of communication because it's a, theater is life. It's not like movies. It's not like music. Theater is life. I'm telling you, I can see the reaction, you know. So that's why theater for me is big because I get to get the fundamental reactions from the consumers. So when the audience comes as they did, and the reaction I get, I'm like, no, this is the authentic reaction. So, and for me, just being able to talk to the guys directly, for me, that for me is priceless.
So thank you so much for watching. He can be best.
So yes, guys, you have seen for yourself. That was GMO. Get me out. Three men, dating one chick, Melissa. Melissa. That chick.
She's an icon. Legend.
She has just three boyfriends. She has a baby. The baby belongs to the three of them. And they are funding the baby left, right, center. Millions. Is that Nairobi for us now?
Absolutely. Oh my How God, do you yes. think? Do you see the price of real estate in Nairobi? Women,
the price
are
of
extra
real estate.
Hard.
I actually saw hard. This TikTok earlier. It was some guy who was like pretending to be a baby, like a baby mama.
Right.
And then, like, every time she wants to get her nails done, she'll take a picture of the kid with like an empty cup.
Saw that.
And she's like, "Your son needs water. Can you send 20,000? And then she goes out with her
because
friend.
This chick collected 900,000, 1.2, and then 2 million, according to the how she rates
each boyfriend.
Bag. Listen,
yeah.
listen.
Wow.
Here we don't shame hustle. We
get that bag.
Hustle.
Secure that bag. Secure that bag, sis.
But talking
do
about
whatever
that bag, still well, let
bag.
Me ask. Theater has been underrated in Kenya.
Mm-hmm.
We have good plays, we have good actors. Are we going to plays? Are we checking out what's going on?
I personally haven't been to a play in a minute. I think the COVID thing kind of like put it in the back burner for me. But now that you see it getting a bit more attention, I'm like, I need to be in the theater because the experience is very different. Like he said, it's not like watching a movie.
Yeah, it's definitely
like being
not.
In touch with, and they kind of break the fourth wall sometimes and they interact with you as a as an audience. And I love that part of it where you get to feel the emotions, the raw feelings, which is absolutely fantastic. And as a Kenyan, you should support local talent. Go for plays.
100%.
See things that you can actually relate to. Because when will Tony Stark come and save you?
What would you expect from plays? And
for me personally, I love watching things live. Like I love watching musicals. I've always, growing up, I was always part of the school musical.
Isha is pretending to be humble here. She's in a whole band. She is the live experience.
She's a whole live
experience. Okay, is the live experience.
Since Laura let the cat out of the bag, I am part of a band. We're called Little Bit Hutke. So when we go perform out there, we bring that that
live.
Connection.
That live.
You know, the live connection. Right. You have to connect with your audience. You have to connect with the people within the audience. And I feel like that's something I expect from live entertainment in this day and age. We've reached a point where we have resources so easily there. You know, they're so accessible. So why not use the resources that we have? And since you're going to use those resources, bring forward entertainment that's going to have a different level of showcase.
So guys, there you are. So many things happening. I know that this week, all this week, things, not things fall apart, but Francis Ibuga's, what was it called? One of his many good books was on show this week. And so, of course, yes, you need to watch out what's happening. But talking about that, and she was talking about her being the band, her being what? But I'm in between two beauties, Miss Something runners up, Miss Something already, and I'm talking about fashion and everything. I'm just sparing this so I don't expose.
Is it because we are older now? We are of no value.
We are our shelf life. TikTok, Laura, TikTok.
And so, yes, again, Nairobi, there was this chic fashion event. I mean, this is the extreme of them all, where you find all these high-level, high-life kind of girl, where you find the Miss Somethings, where you find all the,
Mr.
you know, all these guys were there. And for us, it's just to find out
what happened.
What happened there? Yeah, I mean, all that elegance.
So Tribal Chic is one of the biggest fashion events that happens in Kenya. Mm-hmm. It happens at the Tribe Hotel, which is at Village Market. Right. And they had all these personalities there that killed every
there was
look.
No room in
starting
the room.
Starting with Susan Kaitani, who opened the runway for Olga Nato.
Correct.
Olga Nato is a fantastic designer. When I used to do runway, I think I did one
Not
runway
just a
for
fantastic.
Her.
She's been to the New York African Fashion Week.
Yeah, the Fashion Week.
She's been to the Keynes Festival.
Yeah, so you can imagine we're talking big names in the industry. Wow. And of course, the models were supplied by Vela Models. A big shout out to Pinet, who's a fantastic coach. And Isha,
I'm
saying this. Okay, all I'm going to say, I'm not going to let anything out there, but all I'm going to say, if you're going to have a chic event, make the budget chic as well. And that's all the tea I'm spilling right now. But I'm not going to say anything
else. But as it is, one of my faves was there. You people know how big I fan for Lucia Musau.
Correct.
She's the director of Elite PR, African Elite PR, and I think she is, listen, I like fine babes. If you're a woman out there and you're a fine babe, you dress nice, you look hot every
we
day.
We all like Lucia.
Step out looking
so,
nice.
So,
we all
so
love Lucia. Lucia, we love you.
A powerhouse.
We love you,
but again,
Lucia.
Last week we had this conversation that people are not going to events, blah, 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 because it's too much money.
Mm.
I mean, guys were paying, was it 10K?
I don't know.
Almost.
It was like 5K beforehand and then like almost 10K or 8K.
So we have a good event, people will pay again. Mm. Right?
I mean, I guess Nairobi is moving ahead in their time, so why not?
In my question, they say, Chesanak to Nailela. Mulieka event here, 750 town, I'm kuenda in KICC.
Yeah, exactly.
You're complaining that an event that people pay. Listen.
Let me stick with your budget.
It's a very lucrative entertainment industry.
Lucrative. Lucrative.
Exactly.
Okay, street models here. As a model, what do you look for or at when you're thinking about dressing for such a chic travel kind of a thing? How am I supposed to
if I could, I'd go in sweatpants.
First of all, I'll start with budget, okay? So I have nothing to say when it comes to dressing.
Right.
If it looks nice, I'll say
I'll
it looks
it,
nice.
Yeah.
But I have nothing nice to say, I'll keep my mouth shut because I can't even afford the things she was wearing. Whether it was garbage or blankets, whatever it was, I can't afford it. So I only talk about the nice things I can see. So budget for me is very important.
I thought every budget for a beauty queen or anybody going for such high-end kind of events is really good money.
Stevens, you know, a lot of us models are bougie on a budget, eh?
Oh, is it?
Well, I wouldn't... Okay, I would personally say, for me, I love shopping on thrift stores on Instagram. That's like my main place where I buy a lot of stuff.
What if they ask you, who dressed you?
I'll say Sandy's thrift store. You know, I'll be like, I got it from Sandy's.
Right.
Listen, for me, style, it doesn't matter about the budget. Right. For me, style has to be an expression
style
of
is
yourself
in your
to
eyes.
Begin with.
Yeah.
Exactly. So it's an expression of who you are. It's just an extension of, this is me, this is what I feel good
100%.
In. And if you're out for public validation, then at least wear clean clothes.
I will tell you, Nairobi is the one place where you will receive the most criticism out there. Maybe not like within your social circles, your inner circles, no. But out there, when you go for, let's say, like an event like Tribal Chic, you can't show up in something that looks cheap or is cheap because you're going to sit there feeling cheap.
It's a fashion event.
That's what I'm thinking. It's a fashion event and we have all these designers who are standing by their people and say, you know, I dress her.
Mm.
I mean, do we go to the thrift shops or do we?
No, I definitely stick to the designers.
That's affordable.
Yeah, of course, something that's affordable. I feel like with the number of designers we have, you can always find something within your budget.
I mean, right. Kenya is a perfect place for that. The range is amazing.
It's amazing, exactly. And for different styles, you can get different value, which is important. And you just need to be out there and look.
Yeah,
if
you have to explore.
If you're a person who's interested in fashion, you'll seek it out and find it.
This is one thing I've learned in Kenya, personally, as a curvy girl. Like, you know, there's not a lot of avenues for us to, like, shop for nice, like, sexy-looking clothing. Mm. Like, personally, that's just my experience. But I genuinely feel that shopping in Kenya needs to take a step further in the sense of inclusivity, number one. Number two, just stepping up their game. Like, you know, I see all these brands in all over the world. Why do we not have them in Kenya? Who is responsible for bringing these foreign investments?
Matiang,
into
I don't know.
You know what? That's another old topic that we're going to discuss on this show. But again, talking about previous week and to the next week, we have a lot coming, and it's Valentine's week.
Ooh. Valentine weekend and all that. Coming.
And we know
where's
that there's
your boyfriend.
You are sitting at home. You
know what? I feel under pressure from girls who just think men are gonna take me out too. Oh, I'm waiting
I'm
for
digging myself out.
Or
I'm
something
staying
like
home.
That. Men are going for men's conference anyway. And by the way, yes, we are not afraid of you guys. Again, at the Surrey Center, there's this event that's taking place. It's a Valentine's event. By the way, it's sponsored by the Standard Group.
Yes.
Yeah. And so if you're that person who just wants to have a good time and a little good time, come Tuesday night, go to the Sarit Center and indulge with us.
I heard it's at the garden, the upstairs garden, the open.
Just to be all that
the
romantic
rooftop
thing
garden.
That.
Oh my God. Romantic being single is probably, although going for an event on Valentine's Day when you're single is probably like a good idea because it's a chance for maybe you might meet somebody there. Your network.
You know, I wanted
to
really
people,
go
like,
for a
yeah.
Valentine's event single so that I could approach people's boyfriends and be like, hey. Call me.
I thought we had a connection last
year. I really wanted to do that, being I'm a saboteur.
I think the event
recently
that,
single.
I think the event that works for you in this case is not that one at the Sarit. I think you go to these other events.
I feel like that's single
that,
shaming.
That my friend is going to be talking about now.
The other event that's happening this weekend.
Yeah. Yes.
So I hear there is, okay, for those people who want the romantic experience, Sarit Center, perfect. Mm. For those who want more of don't want to steal boyfriends, but just wanted to have a good dance, you know, enjoy your night. I hear Alchemist is hosting Vibe Nation. Right. Vibe Nation is a new Kenyan company. It's the perfect vibe for every tribe, is what I saw in their Instagram bio. And they have an event called Spiritual Gangster. Mm. And the French DJ.
Spiritual Gangster.
Right. And it's all about connecting with your spiritual side, enjoying music. And Spiritual Gangster, French DJ Anai B is going to be there. So Vibe Nation
Saturday. Let's meet the Spiritual Gangsters and all that. And let's go to other many events. You know what, guys? There are going to be a lot going on out there. And ECAV events will be there, of course, to bring you all the events.
Absolutely. So head on over to social media and figure out which event you want to try out. But as long as you're there, so am I.
And in the meantime, by the way, as we talk about events, yours faithfully is already out.
Yes.
Going to the next event.
He's going, he's leaving.
Right
guys,
now.
Guys, tuna
right
for
water. Right now.
Happy Kenya Clean Toilet Mission.
And you're visiting Mama Zawadi live in Nairobi. Come with me.
Ah, Selena!
Mama Zawadi, how do you keep your toilets clean?
I use normal detergent and bleach for washing.
The detergent and bleach cleanless can leave behind yellowness, rust, and germs.
Harpic 10 times better cleaning compared to regular detergents and bleach.
And kills 99.9% illness-causing germs in your toilet, including the COVID-19 virus.
Wow, Selena! Nimeamini sasa!
Really?
Yes!
Now that she's part of the mission, the next house is yours.
Sleepwalking through the afternoon. Sleepwalking through the afternoon. Sleepwalking through the afternoon.
Don't live life on repeat. Enjoy your great moments with Minute Maid Delight, a treat that awakens your senses and fills you with vitality. So fill those great moments with the indulgent sensations of Minute Maid, featuring delicious mango, tropical and apple flavors. Minute Maid, filled with life.
Get 2 months of Showmax for the price of one? What? In a give girl power, that bling binge, hey, squamaka, and legendary action hero energy, whoa! The thrills and chills keep out, for the streets, in a give kupindukia. So subscribe now to get 2 months from only 300 shillings for limited time. In a give Showmax.
Oh, yes.
When quoted, you're going to take your oxygen and then you're going to ground it.
KTN Prime Highlights, brought to you by KCB Bank.
We have since filed an anticipatory bail application, which essentially seeks to persuade the court to give us some temporary reliefs to ensure that we do not embarrass or rather cause the unlawful arrest of a senior citizen in the name of Dr. Fred Matiang'i.
Was it a hoax? DCI dismisses alleged plans to arrest former powerful CS Fred Matiang'i as he seeks court protection. Cracking the whip drama as Lang'ata MP Felix Odiwuor is kicked out of a party parliamentary group meeting following a state house visit. Elsewhere, one person dead, three still trapped and eight rescued after a gold mine collapses at Galagala area, Kakamega County.
He always prepared for the battle. That's why they say he was obsessed with success.
Also in this bulletin, family, relatives and friends of the late Professor George Magoha pay their tributes during a memorial mass for him.
As a woman in business, let KCB fire up your female-led and made enterprise, KCB Flame. To find out more, WhatsApp 0711-087-087 or call 0711-087-000 and visit us at any KCB branch countrywide.
Ladies and gentlemen, can you make some noise on Twitter and tell her how much has made you happy this time?
Hashtag Naomi on E-curve.
Yes. Bragging 84 point something thousand followers.
Are we correct? Is that correct?
1.8 million likes. And one extra fan tonight.
You stalked her.
Even, listen, even my soda is overexcited. Did you see? It just, it exploded. It exploded. Why? Because the real baddie Angie is in the building.
The real one. Woo-woo! I don't care about the video vixen. This is the video vixen I'm looking at today.
She turned Boutros from shrap god to shrap legend.
What? Exactly.
She made Boutros' career.
You did it.
Listen, it's not the other way around. she made Boutros' career. And thank you so much for Boutros for giving us that banger. Mm. But the one thing I like about Naomi is her face when she's dancing. Let me tell you.
But before we get there, Laura, before we get there, give the lady a chance to introduce herself. Angie, buddy, tell us.
Okay, my name is Naomi Wanjao, not Angie, okay. But you can still call me Angie. Yeah, you know me by the dance, Angie, Pale TikTok.
Yeah, you know her already. She doesn't even, actually, you know what, you don't even have to introduce yourself. But tell us a little bit about what you do. Go for it.
Yeah, so I kind of make dancing videos, like the real ones, not the ones which are rehearsed, you know. Oh. There's the rehearsing part. Yeah. Now I post the rehearsing parts before when you know that bloopers. Style, you know. Yeah, those are the bloopers, actually. So I just try, like, to make something real, something everybody can relate to in the house. You feel like dancing, but your dancing is not that good. And just
having
fun. Yeah,
you're just enjoying.
Listen, there's no one who's that good of a dancer. Like, we had Cardi B here from Lolongo just last week. That's what she calls herself. It's not me.
No, but she actually is a good dancer.
She is a very good dancer. Not all of us are like that. Some of us just go on
Laura needs to let go of Cardi B. Laura, leave it in last week.
I'm a big fan. No, but some of us just do vibes, and that's exactly why I like Naomi's content, because it's vibes. It's what you do when you're in the house.
It's natural, yeah.
It's what you feel like when you're in the house. You know, like a move. You have like a secret one that you don't show anyone.
Yeah, that one.
So the trending video, Angie Buddy, tell us how... What did you think it would go viral? Like, what were you thinking? How did it happen? Tell us.
So I was just in the house, as you saw, like, with sweatpants and everything.
Yeah.
So I was just looking in the house. Then I was scrolling TikTok. Then I saw Asia doing the Angie. I was like, hey, that ka song, Angie. Yeah, then I said, okay, let me just record. Put the phone. At first, since it was my sleeping sweatpants, because I have thick thighs.
Yes.
They don't lie. Thick thighs don't lie.
There was a white carash between the thighs. There was a white carash.
I'm really sorry.
So when I took the first video, it was showing. I was like, no.
Not this time.
Up on a band.
So it's not that natural. Yeah. Some things have to be slightly.
So that's why I was pressing my thighs like this. So that it doesn't show in the video. So I just took the video and... I posted it just like that.
How? Where did this confidence? You just, you're like, I don't care. Yeah, that's the worst that could happen.
Actually, I don't really care. Like, wow. I just don't care.
I love that.
A big round of applause for that.
I really want to be you in my next life, because this life I have failed. I really failed. But I'm coming back. And I asked you the question, do you now have to keep the long hair? Because it's a trademark.
I kind of have to.
You really do have to.
Yeah, I kind of have to.
Magic Designs, Liz Clement,
guys,
the other place there.
Why don't you...
Here you go.
This is
your time
influencer.
To shine.
Yes. This is your influencer right here for all the weaves, all the braids, everything, the butterfly locks, whatever you...
This
is right here. What am I saying?
Reach out. Yeah. So the song is done by Boutros, a fantastic artist who we highly respect in the industry, in the shrap game. Did he reach out in any way?
No.
Okay.
He didn't reach out.
I knew
out.
He was a hater from the beginning. I mean, I was telling you guys.
Yeah, well, on your side. Don't worry.
I told you guys he was a hater.
Yeah, did
joking.
You meet him?
Yeah, I did meet him. The person who reached out was the person who was organizing the meet and grill. So that's where he went. Boutros was, yes, performing. Then, like, a day, two days before the event, he DM'd you saying, you're doing a great job.
Nice.
Ni. He DM'd you?
Yeah.
That's so cool. I think Boutros is a fantastic artist. I'm joking about all that. And so I'll tell you my experience with Angie. Mm-hmm. So I watch the video and I'm laughing. I'm like, this is a comedian. And then I hear her voice and I'm like, stop. Can you stop it right there? Can you stop it? You're just a serious person. Like, with stuff going on.
Yeah.
I really thought you did comedy or something, because then I saw the video about Shakira and then I started looking at you.
Shakira? Can you do the shake for us? Shakira? Shakira, is that you? Lole.
But with TikTok changing, a lot of people are getting recognized. You get fame randomly. Yeah. You never know when it's your day.
Sure.
Why do you enjoy making such videos? Why do you enjoy being on TikTok, sharing your videos of you on an everyday, on having a normal...
because it's fun for me. It doesn't have pressure. Like, you don't have to change. You don't have to put on some makeup. You don't have to do hair. I do it with a bonnet. Literally, I could just wake up and just post a video and still it will be fine. Then I want people to get the joke. Mm-hmm. Plus, it's about the confidence. Like, you can see a lot of TikTokers, especially if they're dancing, they have to do that feat. You have to look good. You have to rehearse. Mine is just a one-time thing.
That's
just
me. I'm the one who takes like 10. You know, I was so traumatized the other day. All my drafts for TikTok got deleted. You know, when you move to a new phone, sometimes your drafts. So I was so angry. But then I realized, I thought to myself, why am I angry for something I never even posted. Had the confidence to post?
Yeah.
And then I saw your content. And it's so ironic how your TikTok actually came on my For You page. It's like TikTok was listening to my mind. I know you're in my phone, FBI investigator.
Please remember, it's a Chinese app.
Whoa. Okay, let's not talk about that. But anyways, I saw your content and it popped up on my feed. And I was like, I shouldn't be upset about things I was never like confident enough to post, and then I regretted it so much because I was like, if only I had posted I would have never felt that loss from inside, you know. And I see that, like, you're literally glowing with like so much confidence, and that's something I resonate with because I've grown up in a place like Kenya is obviously it expects you to be a certain way, especially when you're in the eye of the media.
100%.
But to see you being natural and raw and so comfortable in yourself, it really empowers younger girls to you know, just be happy and be yourself. Like,
be happy.
Be yourself. Be happy. And be comfortable.
I was telling my best friend recently, I have a hard time on TikTok because I'm not free to be myself. So when I see people like Naomi, and then you have conversations, which I'm very lucky because not everyone gets to interact with Naomi, you know, and be like, she's cool vibes. I see a little bit of myself in her. And we can have the office voice, but you can have the videos.
Exactly, exactly.
You being you, which is fun. Mm. Did your friends and folks see the video and then all like, Sasta,
actually, my family, and I don't have that much friends, like Kidogo too, like 3 or 4, but they know me. They're like, it's trending, but we know her. She's behind the scene, it's even worse than that. So they're like used to me and everything. Mm. They're happy for me that.
But and when you say you only have a few friends, you have us as well. Yeah. And with friends comes games.
Yes.
And we're going to play a game with you today, Naomi.
Okay.
We are playing My Baby Daddy Is. Ooh. So let me explain the game to you a bit, okay? Mm-hmm. You just have to think of a celebrity who you would picture as your baby daddy. Mm-hmm. I've thought about too many. There's like a roster running through my mind right now. But
Isha.
I'm of a ripe age. Okay, I want you to think of who your baby daddy. Yeah. I'm telling you, Laura, today English is not Englishing.
If you're the Kenyan man, confusing Isha. So Macau.
So if you have a baby daddy in your mind, I want you to give us hints as to who this baby daddy is, and we have to guess who the guy is. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
But you can give us categories like this person is from Kenya, America, Canada, whatever. So let's begin. Mm-hmm. My baby daddy is
Under the influence.
Listen, first of all, that's not your baby daddy. Can somebody get this babe upset? Because you're not going to talk about Chris Brown like that when I'm sitting right here. Okay?
That's her baby daddy.
That's my baby daddy. I've been thinking about it my whole life. My whole life. Well, not here. Okay. Know me. Yes, mama.
You know
Let's
how
go.
I know.
No, I don't even have flip, but.
Let's go.
Yo, she could actually take you, Laura. I'm not kidding. I don't know.
All right. Did I get it right?
Yeah.
Chris Brown. That's your baby daddy. Yeah. Laura, now I know your baby daddy was taken away from you. And that's what happens in Nairobi.
Yeah.
Hey, watch your man. Laura, who is your baby daddy?
I'll settle. Fine. I don't want you, but you can take the credit. My baby daddy. Dude, I can't even think about anybody else. Who's going to join
this? My mind is discombobulated.
Hey.
Come on, Laura. Who's your
baby
daddy?
My baby daddy is Kenyan.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
My baby daddy dated Vera Sidika for some reason I don't know. Mm-hmm. My baby daddy is a singer.
Come on.
My baby daddy is.
No,
I'm not happy.
Otile. Yes. Well done, ladies and gentlemen. And that was My Baby Daddy Is. I am too young to have a baby daddy.
Okay.
So I will not participate in this game.
Okay.
But you know what? Inshallah, I get a good baby daddy.
All right, guys, that was my baby daddy right here on eCam. Listen, Naomi, thanks so much for coming through.
Thank you for having me.
I absolutely love your energy. I love your vibes. I was going to ask you about the tattoo, but I will definitely ask you about it offset. It's a beautiful one.
She's been staring at it this whole time. Yeah. I was literally looking at it. I'm like, Laura, stop. I'm like trying to send the signal. Stop looking at the tattoo.
I watched this. I went to this rabbit hole. Anyway, you know TikTok and the way it works. So, guys, this is Naomi Wanjau with us on set. Don't forget to give us your social media handles. Definitely where
TikTok,
people can find you.
Naomi Wanjau, Facebook Naomi Wanjau, Instagram Naomi _ Wanjau _, Twitter Naomi _ Wanjau _.
All right. Yeah.
So basically everywhere Naomi Wanjau. Wanjau.
Yeah.
You know
where
you find
me. I don't know if you're going online to look for Angie. Yeah. And if you're an Angie, change your name.
In fact, if you search Angie Dance Challenge, she's the first person that pops up. Okay, so yeah, she's taken that name to Angie Naomi Wanjau. Whatever you wanna say, she's there. She's everywhere. Mm.
All right, guys, reach out to us on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter at KTN Home. And we're always here for a good time. Isha, where can we find you on social media?
Well, you can find me on socials at Isha _Jobanputra on Instagram. On Facebook, it's Isha Jobanputra. If you have trouble spelling that, you can find me on TikTok, which will take you to my Instagram, which will take you to my Facebook. That is What's Your Issue.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for joining us on eCurve. Come through next week where we have a fantastic show lined up for you. You can find me at Lauren Bath on all my social media handles and check out YouTube. I'm coming there shortly. So have a great evening. Keep it eCurve.